to my Uber and Lyft friends in Los Angeles and surroundings, you know that many of the trips might take you to Orange County, San Diego, if you're lucky, out to Ventura. But if you're starting your day off in LA, right, I get asked this question again and again and again. I'm just not making the money in the Uber SUV and the Uber LUX, or the Lyft SUV and the Lyft LUX classes, right? There's just too many drivers, not enough bookings floating around. Now, if you've invested into an expensive vehicle, like I'm sitting right now in a $100,000 Escalade Platinum, you've got to make it work for yourself, right? Otherwise, you're in the minus very, very quickly. You can't even keep up with payments. You have to set that money aside for the TCP, for the California limo license, the commercial license. You got to get yourself a good commercial insurance. And yes, those are two pretty big expenses. The one obviously monthly, the insurance, and the other one is an upfront investment, you could say, into a limo company, because you have to be available and drive private clients. Now, if you're in LA, the one thing you got to obviously know is where are all the high-end hotels, and I'm talking like, let's say, the Montage or the Peninsula or the Wilshire and Beverly Hills, the Bel Air Hotel, hotels around Santa Monica, the Lowe's, Casa del Mar, Shutters. You know, those are super expensive hotels, $300-$400 upwards per night. And yes, those people can easily afford Lux vehicles and SUV vehicles, and those are great places to be at, right? But guess what? You're there competing with many, many other cars. Have you ever driven out to Nobu at night, let's say after the first seating, 9, 10 p.m., people are leaving, and you'll see 10 other cars floating around, right? So in order not to compete with these at all times, you got to make yourself available to private clients. You got to build out your private client base. And there's nothing better than offering tip-top service, quality service, cold waters on board, Evian or Fiji waters, magazines, newspapers, mints, and then having a variety of magazines that have your business card, a card attached to them, right? You just staple your business card, you put on the back seat so it's visible there. You want to engage in a conversation where the people say, is this your business card? May I take it? Should. You may take it. You can also take the magazine if you wish, right? You want to really pamper these people and say, by the way, I do long trips to, you know, LAX, Burbank, Universal, Disneyland. Anytime you, your relatives, your friends need a trip, just contact me. And, you know, let me know what you want. If you want a coffee or anything before I arrive, I'll gladly get it for you, right? And the more you care about them, the more you make that initial first small little investment into them, you know, a coffee and a couple of magazines is not going to set me back much, right? And I've got the client for life. Now, the most important thing is that you drive safe, you keep your distance, you don't do crazy braking, you don't do tailgate driving where you drive up the person's backside and make your passengers nervous. You're going to lose that person there, and then you keep your distance, you keep to the speeds. This is what these clients are looking for, right? And start building out your private base, so you start getting in private emails and text messages and bookings. Why? Thanks, of course, to the TCP license that you invested in. Thanks to the commercial insurance, now you can do that. So if you're on the two platforms, Uber SUV or Lyft SUV, now the Uber SUV is closed, so you definitely want to be on the Lyft SUV, maybe even on the Uber XL, the Lyft Plus. The more categories, the better. The more trips you can get so that you can recruit private clients, the better, right? And I just showed you how to do that. So if you have any further questions about the SUV and Lux classes, please give me a call. I'm a veteran in that field, and I've helped hundreds and hundreds of drivers in this city specifically and other big metropolitan cities achieve their success, achieve 20-30% more than the average person. Also consider, you know, you're in a big city here with very large music and concert venues like the Rose Bowl, the Staples Center, the Forum, the Hollywood Bowl, the amphitheater, Novo, Microsoft Theater. I could go on and on and on. So if you are not on top of those dates and events and sports events, whether it's the Dodgers baseball, Staples basketball, or you know the LA football team, if you're not on top of those events and know when they end, you're going to lose out on a lot of business. So make sure you have a 30-day itinerary all set out for the next month. Again, if you need help on that, please shout. And if you want to start in these categories, reach out to me. Let's have a phone call. Sign up under my code, under my Uber and Lyft code, and I will gladly train and mentor you to master these two categories. Have a fantastic day from the Rideshare Professor.